Hi friends! In this video, I will show you how to profile Java applications in Docker containers using Java Flight Recorder. Java Flight Recorder, or JFR, is a low-overhead profiling and diagnostics tool built into the OpenJDK, so you don't have to install it manually. We can profile the application right from the start. We can attach to the running application and profile it at any point in time. And we can also observe the running Java application in JDK mission control. So let's look at all three scenarios. First, let's look at how we can start a JFR recording right at application startup. You can take any application. I'm using Spring Pet Clinic. And here's the Docker file that we will use. At the first stage, we are building a jar file, and I'm using Liberica JDK container with Liberica JDK Lite and minimalistic Alpaketa Linux. Liberica JDK is recommended by Spring, so it will be a perfect choice for a Java runtime if you develop Spring applications. At the second stage, we transfer the jar file into the fresh base image with JRE. Know the options that we must specify to start the recording. The most important one is start flight recording. You can set different parameters. For instance, you can set the duration of the recording. In this case, it's 30 seconds. And you can also set the file name. And in this case, it's going to be a recording.jfr. And it will reside in the TMP directory of our container. So we are telling the JVM that we want to start the JFR. And we specify these options. And you can also specify the unlock diagnostic VM options and debug non-save points to make the profiling more accurate. Well, that's pretty much it. Let's build a container the usual way with the Docker build command. Alright, our image is ready. Now let's run the application. No additional options are necessary, we are simply specifying the port for the application. As you can see, the recording has started. So that's a success, we did everything right. And now let's just push some buttons while we are waiting. Okay, as you remember, the file with the recording is in the TMP directory of the container. So we have to start the container again. Now we need to find out its ID to be able to copy the file from the container. And this is the command to do that. Here it is, our ID. And now you can retrieve the file to the current directory with Docker CP. So let's specify the ID and the file that we want to copy. All right, here it is. Here's our file. We can open it to analyze the data in JDK Mission Control. Mission Control is an open JDK project. It's open source, so you need to download it. You can get Liberica Mission Control, for instance, and I'm using that. So let's open the file. And here it is, our recording with the data. Now let's see how we can attach the container when it is already running. If we don't want to profile the application right from the start, we can use the JCMD tool to control the JFR. The JCMD is part of the JDK, but here is the catch. It is recommended to build final images with the Java wraps based on the JRE, which is a subset of JDK. So we don't want to use the full JDK in the container image as we don't want to make it unnecessarily bigger, right? And besides, we also don't want to enter the target container with the privileged access. Plus, the container may be based on distroless or slimbase image and not contain the shell. So we might not even be able to enter it. For all these cases, we have one solution, ephemeral containers. They are started at an arbitrary point of time and run temporarily to accomplish some task, for instance, to perform the profiling or debugging session. So we can attach the ephemeral container to the target container and profile it from there. Okay, so now let's rebuild our application container. Let's remove all the additional options, we don't need them anymore. And now we have a very simple Docker file, and its only purpose is to build the application and run it. Okay, let's build the container image. Alright, it's ready, and now it's time to build an ephemeral container. We will need this Docker file, it's super simple, and it only includes the JDK. As you remember, the JDK contains the JCMD tool that we need. Okay, let's build this container image. So now let's run the containerized application with a standard command, no additional options are necessary. Let's simply specify the D flag to run the container in a detached mode. Great. So now to attach the ephemeral container, we need several options. So Docker run, and then we need PID container to place the ephemeral container in the same PID namespace as our application. And for that purpose, we need the name of our container. Now we also need the IT flag to run the ephemeral container in the interactive mode. And we also need to add the capability system admin to gain access to the JVM performance information. And finally, you may need to add this flag, and that is security option unconfined, to allow access to the container. Right, so this is the whole command. Let's run it. Great, so now we are inside the ephemeral container. From here, run the JCMD command to find out the PID of the Java application running in a container we have attached to. And finally, you can start a JFR recording with the JCMD command using the PID of the process. And you can also specify necessary options, for example, the duration, let's set it to 15 seconds, and the file name. After the profiling is complete, you can retrieve the recording from the target container with the Docker CP. So let's exit our ephemeral container. Our application container is still running, so we don't have to restart it. Let's just find out its ID. Alright, and now Docker CP and the container ID. Great, and here it is, our file with the profiling data. Alright, what if you want to monitor the running application and receive profiling data in real time? For that, we can use the JDK Mission Control. It is an open source set of profiling and monitoring tools with a user interface. Okay, let's return to our Docker file and change it a bit. Let's add several options. We need to enable the connection to remote JVM. So we need a bunch of options. You can actually copy them from our article on profiling Docker containers with JFR. Here they are. So let's copy the whole entry point and I will explain what each option means. Right, so first, the Sun Management JMX Remote option enables the monitoring from a remote system. RMI's server hostname is used to specify the hostname. So I'm running the application on a local machine, so I'm setting this hostname for localhost. Of course, if you're running the application on the server, you should specify the exact hostname. Right, then JMX RMI port is used for specifying the RMI port, and the JMX remote port is used for the JMX port, and both must have the same value. In this case, it's 7091. And next, we have JMX remote authenticate set to false and JMX remote SSL set to false. These are used to set the JMX authentication and SSL if required. So set them to the values you need, but in this case, we set them to false for simplicity's sake. All right, let's rebuild the container image. Our image is ready, and now let's run it. And when specifying the command for running the container image, we should specify the application port and the connection port. So the application port is 8080, and the connection port is 7091. All right. After starting a container with the enabled JMX, you need to connect to the remote JVM. Let's open a library commission control. And now we need to select a new custom JVM connection. Specify the host name, in my case it's localhost, and the port, so in my case it's 7091. Click Finish, and after that, you can connect to the JVM in your container. Great! We can now observe our running application. We can monitor different indicators in real time. And I think it looks really beautiful. In this video, we learned how to profile Java applications in containers using the Java Flight Recorder. In one of the following videos, we will look at profiling containerized Java apps with a sync profiler, another low overhead profiler. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and until next time!